Good morning and welcome to my morning rant. Think about the hottest day that you can remember being in. Side, maybe you're mowing the lawn or whatever. Maybe you're just walking in a park or whatever it is. But think of this hot day. And now I want you to do me a favor and think of a nice cold glass of water. You're drinking a nice cold glass of water. Think of that water hitting the back of your throat and how it feels going down inside your body. Tell me about that. Isn't it feel really good? You're drinking this thing. It's just absolutely the best water in the world. So what just happened to you as you think about that and picture that in your mind? Bible, or not even the Bible, science call that it's a physical response that's triggered by a mental stimulus. And so this is the type of response that God wants you and I. He wants us to be trained by the Word and not by the world. And let me talk to you a little about that. You know, you're living in the world for a long time and you just got saved. And so you picked up a few habits and you've been programmed by your flesh your sinful nature. And you had no problem with that. It was just, you know, you did certain things out of repeated experience. It caused you to react a certain way. But after you became born again, in the Bible, God demands you to be trained by His Word and not by the world system. But I'll give you an example of what I'm talking about. And people that have heard me talk on my podcast, they've heard me talk about this. You're driving in a car, you're enjoying your music, and you're not paying attention to anything. You're following the speed limit. You're doing everything right. You're having a great time. You look up in your rearview mirror and you see the cop car behind you. I bet you most of us will have a response to that. And that response is already programmed within your body and its system, and you naturally will probably hit your gas, slow down, and start, you know, checking to see if you're speeding or any type of that stuff. And so your physical response to that police officer was programming you, and so it wasn't anything else. It's just you were in this situation and your whole system responded to it. A little fear kicked in, your body reacted to that thought, the emotional thought, which produces all of these things. You know, as I mentioned to you, what science calls it, you know, this physical reaction by a mental stimulus. You were picturing all kinds of things about this police officer already, and you haven't even engaged. And so the Bible tells us that God wants us to do that. And I'll show you from the Word of God that He does want you and I to be able to be trained by the Word. And so that you and I are then, once we are trained by the Word, we will respond by the Word. Proverbs 4:20 says, "My son, attend to my words, incline thine ears unto my sayings. Let them not depart from your eyes," number one. "Keep them in the midst of your heart, too, for they are life unto those that find them and health to all their flesh." So we see that He wants you and I to go into this Word of His and meditate on it and keep it before our eyes, put it in our hearts, deposit it in us. And why does He want that? And we'll talk about why He wants that. The same situation, the same scenario that took place with the cop and while you're driving is the same thing. The same response that you got when you drank the water is that same thing. That physical reaction triggered by a mental stimulus. And so that Joshua 1:9-9 says, "Keep this book of the law always on your lips, meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Not be afraid, not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. So we see this a principle that God wants us to learn about who we are as we study the Word. And the purpose of studying that is so that when situation comes in our life, that the enemy brings a situation, you and I can respond because we have been programmed by the Word of God. And so we have been trained. The Bible tells us that you and I are spirit, soul, and a body, and that we ought to know this. And this is fundamental to knowledge, to know who you are as an individual. 1 Thessalonians 5:23 says it this way: My God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. Now he explains, may your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's what I said to people. You see that combination there, your spirit, soul, and body. For you and I to walk in perfect faith, we have to align that part of our body, our soul, and our spirit. Once they are aligned together and they come in agreement, the spirit man is leading this individual, leading Ken Primus. And my soul, when my soul says he prays that our soul prospers, Paul prays, he says, he pray that our soul prosper and being helped. So we know that the soul and the spirit, when we bring them in unity, they will then now bring the flesh of the man in ordinance. And once we do that, we are in total 100% alignment, and we are in faith, and we'll get what we want. But I wanted to go back and talk to you guys about this training of the word, by the word, and not by our circumstances. So first of all, we have to agree on certain things. What is the Word of God? If we're going to put our faith in this Word, what is it we're doing? You know, what is it like? What's the Word of God? What is it like? So the Bible tells us what it's like. When we look at Proverbs 35, it says, every word of God is flawless or pure. He is a shield to those who take refuge in him. So we know, one, that God's word is pure. It is flawless, as it says. And so the Bible tells us in Romans 3:4, when we look at the word of God, it's synonymous with him. It is his word. It's who he is. And so it tells us in Romans 3:4, it says, not at all. Let God be true, and every human being a liar, as it is written, so that you may be proved right when you speak and prevail when you judge. So we know from that scripture that every man is a liar except for God. The Bible tells us this. You know, he says that let men or human beings are liars, because we have the corrupted seed of Lucifer, that the Bible calls him a father of lies. So the scripture tells us that that let God be true. So if God is true, that means that his word is true. Once his word is true, then you and I can then, we have a choice whether we want to believe this word of God or not. Romans, I think it's Hebrews 4:12, for the word of God is alive, it is active, it is sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even the dividing of the soul and the spirit, joint and marrow. It judges the thought and the attitudes of the heart. That is the power of God's word. So this is the tool that is going to be, as you and I are studying this, we are then depositing truth in our spirit, and we are to be guided by truth. We are prompted to be guided by flawlessness. Flawlessness is the word of God. The Bible tells us that this God, then, after we see what his word is like, then we have to take a look quickly at who he is like. You know, And here's another scripture about the word of God, 119, Psalms 119:9. How shall a young man cleanse his ways? By taking heed thereunto according to the word. And this is our goal is to end up here as we walk through and learn about being programmed by the word of God. So we see that this word of God is powerful. We know that in Psalms 119:89 is another place that forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in the heaven. So when we look at the Bible and we look at the word of God on a specific topic, we know that this is the truth. It is settled. It is now you and I have to put our faith in this word, in this God. The Bible tells us in Isaiah 40 verses 8, it says, the grass withereth and flowers fall, but the word of our God endures forever. So these are the qualities of God's words, the power of his word. Matthew 24:35, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will never pass away. So God's word is what I'm trying to do, because our goal is to be trained by this so that we can respond accordingly. So we see that as we begin to look at the word of God, it is the truth. So any situation that arises in your life then that is differ from the word of God, then is not truth. It is just a temporary situation. And so you and I have to make understand that that's just a temporary situation. Your sickness is a temporary situation. You can be healed, treated, and by medication and all the other things. And most medicine don't heal you. Most medicine just help to maintain your sickness and disease, like diabetes and high blood pressure, all these other things, these medicine that they have, is just to maintain your disease. Now you can have it that way, or you can have it by the way of God. He says, I am the Lord God that heals you. Take your faith and you go and pursue your healing that way. Or another way is that the sickness overcomes you and you're gone, but it is temporary. And so it is all temporary unless God heals you, because God doesn't treat you. God says, he never said, I'm the God that treats you. He says, I'm the God that heals you. And so there's a difference in that. So our goal then is to be trained by this word and put this word into us, as we see that God told us that we ought to be doing and following this word. He says, as I mentioned to you, keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that ye may be careful to do everything that is written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful in all your ways. How are you going to be successful, young man or young girl, or man or woman, whatever? It says, how shall a young man cleanse his ways? By taking heed thereof according to thy word. You know, so how can a young man keep his ways pure? By keeping watch on himself according to your word, conforming his life to your precepts. That's what we're doing. When a situation arises, we have to have the word inside of us so that we can respond accordingly. We are being trained by the word and not by the world, so that you and I can gain the victory in our situation, and so that you and I can make this testimony. As the psalmist said in Psalms 119, I call all with all my heart, answer me, Lord, and I will obey your decree. I call out to you, save me, and I will keep your statutes. I rise before dawn and cry for help. I have put my hope in your words. My eyes stayed open through the watch of the night, that I may meditate on your promises. Hear my voice in accordance with your love. Preserve my life, Lord, according to your laws. Those who devise wicked schemes are near, but they are far from your laws or your word. Yet you are near to me, O Lord, and all your commands are true. Long ago, I learned from your statutes that you established them to last forever. So that is our testimony as you and I begin to learn how we are going to train ourselves by staying before the Word of God, so that you and I can be conditioned and have a spiritual conditioned response to a situation when it arises to us. That's how we want to do it. We want to train our spirit, because he is there and he's now running the show. So we want to train him so we would have a spiritual response to a natural circumstances that comes before us. And the only way we can do that, it tells us, that by keeping God's word. How can a young man keep his ways pure? By keeping the word of God. And the Bible tells us, folks, that the just shall live by faith, and we walk by faith, not by sight.